Hello friends, we are in the module 2, last topic, that is anodizing of aluminium under corrosion control. Okay, so let us discuss about the anodizing of aluminium in this. Okay, so we discussed about the metallic coatings under the corrosion control. Okay, cathodic protection also is discussed. The last step is inorganic coatings. Okay, they are also called as non-metallic coatings. Fine. What are these inorganic coatings? Here the surface of the base metal will be converted into some other compound. Okay, which will be acting as a barrier to prevent the corrosion. Okay, or the corrosion atmosphere. Okay, it can be done by chemical or by electrochemical reactions. Okay, you'll be knowing, right? Some metals like aluminium or silver, they will be protecting themselves by forming an oxide layer. Okay, and that oxide layer formed is if it is stoichiometric in nature, okay, if it is non-porous, okay, and if it is highly stable, then it will not be supporting the corrosion, right? We discussed factors affecting the rate of corrosion. Fine. So we are forming a layer that is called as a barrier, okay, that will be protecting the metal from further corrosion. Okay, metals they themselves form a layer. Okay, but here it is made in the laboratory artificially. We are making a layer on a base metal, okay, so that it will be protecting the base metal from further corrosion. It is referred to as a inorganic coatings. Okay, under inorganic coatings there are two types are there. One is phosphating, another one is anodizing. Okay, and let us discuss with the anodizing. What is this anodizing? The process of increasing the thickness of the oxide layer on passive metals artificially in acid medium is known as anodizing. You must always write a definition completely, okay, however it is given. Okay, so the process of increasing the thickness of the oxide layer on passive metals artificially in a acid medium is known as anodizing. I told you the metals will be forming a layer on itself, but it will be taking a more time. Okay, and it cannot be so strong like it is made artificially. In the laboratory, it will be made in such a way that it will never get corroded and it will become very strong also, and also it will be looking brighter in appearance also. Fine. In all the way, we are developing the metal surface. Fine. In the case of anodizing. Fine. So, the anodizing of aluminium, the apparatus consists of a tank will be there, okay, plating bath tank will be there, okay, where anode and cathode will be there. Here anode is the article to be anodized, that is our aluminium will be taken as anode, and cathode here will be any inert metal or graphite. Okay, anode is article to be anodized, and the cathode will be any inert metal can be taken as a cathode or graphite will be taken. And important here is the electrolyte consists of a chromic acid and H2SO4, mixture of chromic acid and H2SO4. Okay, you must write this in your explanation, otherwise you will be losing the marks. Very important part. Okay, electrolyte is a mixture of chromic acid and H2SO4. Okay, this is about the diagrammatic representation of the anodizing of the aluminium. Okay, like in industrial, huge apparatus will be there. At a time, thousands of the articles will be anodized. Okay, a typical apparatus is shown here. That's why we can show only one anode and one cathode. Okay, really in practical, it will not be like this. Many number of the things will be anodized at a time. Fine. So, anode is a article to be anodized. That is a aluminium, cathode is any inert or graphite electrode will be taken. Electrolyte taken will be here like chromic acid and H2SO4. And direct current is used here around 45 to 50 degree. Temperature is needed here for this process. Fine. Okay. Let us see the composition of the plating bath. Okay. Aluminium articles. No. The aluminium to be anodized, no, it will be first cleaned like we discussed it, no, in a previous processes. The article to be coated, no, that will be first given pre-treatment. Here the articles of aluminium, no, that is to be anodized, is degreased thoroughly, okay, washed, dried, and then it is subjected to the anodizing process. Okay, and I told you already, it is given in the form of a table. Anode is aluminium, cathode is graphite, electrolyte is sulfuric acid and chromic acid, voltage required is 40 volts, temperature is around 35 volts, 35 to 50 you can rate generally, right? It depends on the thickness required, okay? Thickness required, always know the plating process can be and the thickness can be controlled by maintaining the concentration of the electrodes and also the temperature, okay? So you can generally rate it as 35 to 50 degrees centigrade, and the current density required for this process is around 10 to 20 milliamperes per square centimeters, fine? And the reactions that are taking place in the electrolytic plating bath are at the surface of the anode. What happens is the aluminum will be reacting with water to form a alumina, that is Al2O3 aluminum oxide layer will be formed with the liberation of electrons and H+ ions. Okay, at cathode the H+ ions will be reduced to the hydrogen. So the overall reaction here is when the aluminum is reacting with the water, okay, the products formed are aluminium oxide with the hydrogen. Okay, these are the reactions that are taking place in the electrolytic plating bath in the anodizing process. And here now, in the anodizing process, direct current is required, okay, where the metals is suspended and the oxide layer formed, no, that will be, you know, progressive oxidation of the metal. And this oxide layer, no, it will be acting as a barrier, okay, barrier between the metal and the corrosive environment for further protection of the base metal from corrosion, okay. The oxide layer formed will be so stable that it will be highly stable, it will be, you know, controlling the further corrosion on the surface of the metal. So it will be acting as a, the oxide layer formed will be acting as a barrier to avoid the or to control the corrosion, okay. You know, sometimes here what happens is the layer of the oxide formed will be, sometimes it will be porous, okay, it will be covered by dipping for sometimes in a hot water, okay. When it is, when the article anodized article is kept in sometime with the hot water, no, the porous nature will become proper, okay, and the thickness can be controlled by adjusting the current and bath solution. I told you already, okay, depending on the thickness required, always the current density and the concentration of the solutions are maintained in the plating bath. I think I am clear till here, okay. It's very easy process. Once again, just revise the main points here in the anodizing of aluminium, okay. Anode is aluminium to be anodized, okay. Cathode is any inert metal or graphite, and the electrolyte is a mixture of chromic acid and H2SO4. Current required is around, you know, 40 degree, temperature required is around 35 to 50 degree centigrade, okay. And the current will be adjusted depending on the thickness required, okay. And the anodized articles will be having wide applications in industries. It will be used in everywhere, okay, in industries, in hardwares, computer hardwares, okay, and also in satellites, okay. And due to its minimum maintenance, it will be used in roofs, curtains, staircases, escalators, etc. And it's also used in office partitions, cabins, etc. Okay, because it will not, the anodized articles usually it will not be getting corroded for a long times. Okay, see, this is a pictures. Anodized aluminium will be looking like this after the coating process is over. This is for your information. It will be looking very attractive, shiny in nature, and it will not get corroded. And the layer formed outside the metal will be acting as a barrier to control the further corrosion of the metal. Fine. So this ends with the corrosion chapter. We will be starting next with the metal finishing. And at last, as usual, just go through the electrochemical series, okay. See friends, it's very, very, very simple, okay. Few points to remember, the same things we will be discussing in a different ways in this chapter. The same thing, okay, differently we will be discussing, okay. Like, you know, if whenever you take two metals, any two metals, okay, any two you take, okay, the metal which is present above is always anode. The metal which is present below to it will be always cathode, okay. Let them ask any sort of questions, you can answer, okay. Just remember this series. The metal which is present will be above will be acting as anode, and that will be undergoing corrosion. And the metal which is present below to that metal in the series will be acting as a cathode, and that will get protected. Okay, if you just remember that few points, no, the same thing will be discussed in many different ways. Just take the example of galvanization. Galvanization, what we do? We are coating, you know, zinc on iron, zinc and iron. And zinc, where is where it is present? It is present above the iron. So it comes under anodic metal coatings. Okay. And you know, in tinning, okay, we are coating tin and iron. That comes under cathodic metal coatings. Okay. And when we are discussing about the, you know, differential metal corrosion also, okay, we are taking any two metals as an example, right? If any two combinations of metals are there, okay, so you just see how they are present in the electrochemical series. Okay, the metal which is present above will be always acting as a anode, and the metal which is present below to it will be acting as a cathode. You know that very well. So we showed that the combination of iron and copper. When iron and copper are in combination with each other, okay, iron will get corroded, copper will be protected. If we combine zinc and iron, what will happen? Zinc will be acting as a anode that will get corroded and protect the iron. Okay, very, very, very simple. The same things we will be discussing in the different ways. And cathodic protection we discussed. In cathodic protection, what are we doing? Okay, we are just connecting the zinc with the iron. Once again, the same thing. In different way, we are discussing. When zinc is connected with iron, once again, the same thing. Okay, the zinc will be acting as a anode and iron will be acting as a cathode. It protects. Okay, it is sacrificing its life for iron. So it's called as a sacrificial anode method. Understood? Okay, so the same things will be discussed in a different ways. It's very easy if you understand this. Okay, so please do remember the electrochemical series. It will be much more helpful in this corrosion chapter. Okay, so this ends with the corrosion chapter. Next shortly we'll be starting with the metal finishing chapter. Okay.